Busy for mobile distributor. In this presentation, we will discuss about various features that Busy offers for mobile distributor industry and will discuss how you can use and implement those features in Busy. This video is basically part of our trade specific video in which we pick up a particular trade type and discuss what all features Busy offer for this particular trade type and how you can use those features and implement those features in Busy. First of all, we'll go to Administration, Configuration, Features Options tab. Here we will click the Trade Specific Configuration button. On clicking this button, you can see a list of trade types appearing. Here we'll select the trade type as Mobile Distributor. On selecting the trade type as Mobile Distributor, a list of options is appearing on the screen. You can see various options are enabled by default by Busy. These are the features which we think are important or useful for mobile distributor industry. So we have enabled these features by default. If you do not want to use any of the features, then you can disable that feature. So first of all, here is the Salesman Broker Wise Reporting feature. Then is Enable Serial Number Details, that is you can maintain serial number details with each item. Then Quantity Decimal Place is set to 0. Then is Scheme, you can create or implement almost any type of scheme in Busy. Free Quantity in Vouchers, allow Sale Return in Sale Voucher, that is you can enter Sale Return Quantity in Sale Voucher itself. Bill by Bill Details feature. So we have configured certain warning alarms, enable bank reconciliation, we have enabled bank reconciliation features, post-dated checks in payment receipt vouchers, that is you can enter PDC entries, you can fix credit limits for the parties, then pricing mode we have set to party item wise price discount structure. If you want any other price discount structure, then you can use that also. Then is your auto rounding of final amount in series, and we have also enabled item wise discount feature in series. Click save button to save this configuration. Once this configuration is saved, then our first step would be to create a salesman master. If you make sale purchase with the help of various salesmen or brokers, then you can create the salesman master using salesman add option. Specify the name of the salesman, print name, address of the salesman, then telephone number of the salesman, email ID, and then salesman account to be credited. Here we are selecting the commission on sales account. Next, we will create scheme master. Using scheme master, you can create almost any type of scheme in Busy. To create a scheme master, go to scheme add option. First of all, specify the name of the scheme. Here we are specifying the name as get Bluetooth headset free. Then if the scheme is valid for a particular date range or time range, then you can specify the same criteria here. That is, you can specify the date range or the time range. Then next, you can specify that scheme is applicable for all parties, group of party, one party, and then select the vouchers in which the scheme will be applicable. Here we are selecting the all series of sales voucher. Then scheme to be applied on any individual item or total voucher amount, or you want to apply clubbed on. Then item wise or item group wise, and then is select scheme type. Here we are selecting the scheme type as free discounted different item, that is with the sale of one particular item, another item will be given as free or at discounted rate. Then in the scheme details grid, here we are selecting the items as Samsung Galaxy A8 Star. With one quantity of this item, we are giving the Samsung Bluetooth headset as free. So whenever you will sell a Samsung Galaxy A8 Star, this particular model, a Samsung Bluetooth headset will be given as free. For more details on implementing Scheme Master, you can watch our video uploaded on YouTube. Next, we are creating one more scheme master. Here we are giving the name as extra 5% discount. Specify the date range, select the voucher, and here we are applying the scheme on the voucher basis, and we are selecting the scheme type as discount bill sundry. In the scheme details grid, we are specifying the criteria that when the voucher amount is above 2 lakh rupees, a discount of 5% will be given. So whenever the voucher amount will exceed 2 lakh rupees, an additional discount of 5% will be given. Next, we are going to our item master. Here we are opening item master in modify mode. Assuming you have already created certain items. If you have not yet created items, then you can create items using item add option. Here we are opening Samsung Galaxy A8 Star item in the modify mode, and we are specifying yes in the serial number wise detail option. That means we are enabling serial number wise detail feature for this item. On saving the item master, an item serial numbering type details window is appearing, in which we'll select the numbering type as manual number, as the numbering will be provided by the manufacturer. So we are selecting the manual numbering option for the mobile item. Next, we'll open the account master in modify mode. Here we are basically specifying the credit limit for our parties. We have opened digital word party in the modify mode. On pressing the enter key on the group field, you can see credit limit for account window is appearing, in which we will set the credit limit for this particular party. Here we have specified 1 lakh as maximum allowed credit, which means that whenever the dues or the credit limit will exceed 1 lakh rupees, a warning alarm as configured will be shown on the screen. That is, the credit limit for this party is set to 1 lakh and you are exceeding the same amount. So these are our master's part. We have done with our master part. Now we'll configure the party item price structure. We'll go to configuration, party item price structure, and select the sales option. That means we are defining the party item structure for sales voucher. Here we'll select the party. We are selecting the party as digital world. Then we are specifying that with the item group mobile accessories and smartphones, we are giving different discounts. Whenever you sell an item belonging to mobile accessories group, a discount of 5% will be given, and whenever you are selling any item from the item group smartphone, then 10% discount will be given to digital world party. So this is our party item price structure. Now we will go to our transactions part. First of all, we'll enter a purchase voucher by going to purchase add option, specify the header related details of the voucher, select the item, specify quantity. On pressing the enter key on the unit field, an input serial number wise detail window is appearing, in which we'll enter the first serial number. Here we are entering the IMEI 1 number of the mobile in the item serial number field. In the description 1 field, we are entering the IMEI 2 of the mobile. And in the description 2 field, we are specifying the color of the mobile. On clicking the generate continuous number button, you can see a screen is appearing. Here you can specify the first serial number and the number of serial numbers to be generated. Busy will then generate the specified amount of serial number by incrementing 1 in the first serial number. Here we are selecting another item. It's 2 pieces also we are selling, and we have specified the serial number details for this item also. Another item, Samsung Galaxy A50, we are selecting, and we have specified its serial number details also. Specify the bill sundry in the voucher, click save button. On saving the voucher, you can see a bill by bill adjustment of amount window is appearing, in which we are creating a new reference for this particular transaction. That means whenever we'll pay the amount of this particular transaction, then we'll adjust the same in this particular reference. Next, we are entering a sales voucher. Specify the header related details of the sales voucher, select the item. You can see on the screen, on selecting the item, Samsung Galaxy A8 star with 5 quantity, Samsung Bluetooth headset is given as free. Adjust item serial numbers window is appearing, in which you will select the serial numbers against which you are making the sale. Specify the price per piece of the item in the item price and discount window. You can see clearly the items on which scheme is applicable are appearing in a different color. Then we are selecting Samsung's Galaxy A30 items, specify its serial number details and price also. On saving the voucher, you can see a scheme info window is appearing, which is clearly showing 2 schemes, that is on sale of 5 items of this particular mobile, 5 headsets will be given as free, and since the voucher amount is exceeding 2 lakh rupees, additional 5% discount will be given. You can see in the bill sundry, an additional 5% discount bill sundry is applied in the voucher. If you remember, we have created the same scheme master with the name extra 5% discount. Then bill by bill adjustment of amount window is appearing, in which we have created reference for this particular transaction also. Now Busy is asking to print the sales invoice. We are printing the sales invoice in standard format, but first we are configuring the standard format. And here we are specifying yes in the serial number wise details option, as we want to print the serial number details of the item in the invoice. You can see on the screen, serial number details are also being printed. Next, we are entering one more sales voucher. Enter header related details of the voucher, select item, select serial number against which you are making the sale. Then item price and discount window is appearing, which is clearly showing a discount of 10%. If you remember, for the digital world party, we have specified the party item price structure that whenever we'll make sale to this particular party, a discount of 5% or 10% will be given to the party. So Busy has automatically shown the 10% discount here. Specify the bill sundry in the voucher, click save button to save the voucher, and the commission related details. Then we are creating reference for this particular transaction also, and click the OK button to save this voucher. Next, we are entering one more sales voucher. Enter header related details of the voucher, selecting the item as Samsung Galaxy M20, and we are selling 2 pieces of this item. Specify the serial number details of the item you are selling, and then in the next row we are selecting the item as Samsung Galaxy A50. Here we are entering the quantity as -1, which means this is a case of sale return. That is, in the sale voucher we are entering a sale return quantity also. This voucher implies that we are selling two pieces of Samsung Galaxy M20 and one piece of Samsung Galaxy A50 is returned by the customer. You can see the item with negative quantity is showing amount also in negative. That means this particular amount will be deducted from the total invoice amount. Click save button to save the voucher. Now we will be entering a payment voucher. That is the payment we will make to our party from whom we have made the purchase. In this payment voucher, we'll select the type as PDC, that is, this is a post-dated check entry, and we are specifying the date as 20th May. Voucher date is 15th May, but the PDC date is 20th May. Select the party. You can see bill by bill adjustment of amount window is appearing, in which you'll adjust the reference that you have created in the purchase voucher. Credit the bank account and click save button to save the voucher. Next, we are entering a receipt voucher, that is the payment we have received from our parties. Here we are selecting the type as regular. We are creating the digital wallet party, and in the bill by bill adjustment of amount window, we are adjusting the reference we have created in the sales voucher for this particular party. Debit the bank account and click save button to save the voucher. We are entering one more receipt voucher. This is a regular voucher for mobile hut party. Here also we are making the bill by bill adjustment that we have created in the sales voucher, and click save button to save the voucher. Till now we have done with our transactions part. Now we'll be viewing the reports. We'll go to display. You can see a lot of reports are appearing. First we'll view the bank reconciliation reports. Here we are viewing the show all entries report. We have selected the HDFC bank, and on the screen you can see it's showing two entries, that is two receipt vouchers that we have just entered for the HDFC bank. Here on pressing F4 key, feed clearing date window is appearing, in which you can enter the clearing date of the voucher also. If you want, you can clear full voucher also. This is beneficial if there are more than one parties in the voucher. Next, we are viewing the bank reconciliation statement for the HDFC bank, and on the screen you can see complete bank details are appearing on the screen. Next is your commission calculation report. We are viewing this report for all the salesmen, and on the screen you can see commission related details of all the salesmen of the company. Next are your scheme report. Here we'll be viewing scheme used in voucher report. Specify the name of the scheme. Here we are specifying the name as get Bluetooth headset free, and busy is showing the voucher in which this particular scheme is used. So with this report you can view the details of the voucher in which the specified scheme has been used. Then is your serial number wise reports. You can view complete serial number wise report. We are viewing item serial number history report. Specify the item serial number, and on the screen you can view the details of the vouchers in which this particular serial number has been used. First there is a purchase, then there is a sale, and then again there is a sale, but this is quantity in as. If you remember, we have entered a sale return quantity in the sale voucher. Next, if you want, you can view credit limit variance report under MIS reports. This report will show the credit limit of the party, balance and the variance. All these details will be shown in the report. So these all are the features that Busy offer for the mobile distributor industry. Hope after going through this presentation, you would be able to use and implement these features in Busy. Thanks for watching. For more videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel.